When you see Bernie Sanders in person for the first time, a few things stand out. First off, he's a big talker. At this Seabrook town hall, Sanders spoke for well over an hour, not including the Q&A. Another surprise, he's funnier than you'd think.
Sleeves are going off, probably take my shirt off in a few minutes.
Also, Sanders is as aggressive a cultural warrior as he is an economic populist.
All of you know what they mean by family values. And what they mean is that women in America should not have the right to control their own bodies. I disagree.
But of course, that economic populism is Sanders' claim to fame. And in Seabrook and Portsmouth, where he opened a new campaign office yesterday, it constituted the core of his message.
When you have one family, the second wealthiest family in this country, spending more money than either of the two major political parties, my friends, you're not talking about democracy, you're talking about oligarchy, and that we will not allow to take place.
Here's another striking thing about Sanders' approach. He doesn't really seem to like to talk about foreign policy very much. At that event in Seabrook, he was on the topic for maybe 5 minutes, saying he opposed the second Iraq war and that he backs President Obama's deal with Iran. So when Sanders took questions in Portsmouth, I asked him about some other pressing topics.
How would you respond to the war in Syria, the rise of ISIS, and the refugee crisis in the Middle East and Europe?
It goes without saying, in terms of the refugee crisis, this is a horrendous humanitarian crisis. That means that Europe has got to react. It means that the United States has got to react. It means also that very wealthy Gulf region countries like Saudi Arabia and the UAE and Kuwait have got to react as well. ISIS has got to be defeated. But it cannot be the United States alone that does that. The hand-to-hand fighting, the troops on the ground, have got to be done, in my view, and led by the Muslim countries in the region.
One final point. When Sanders speaks to his adoring supporters, he casts himself as a revolutionary.
What we are trying to do in this campaign actually has never been done in the modern history of our country.
But also insists that his ideas are totally mainstream.
And not allowing billionaires to buy our political process is not a radical idea. It's what this country is supposed to be about.
It's a tricky balance, and if the polls are right, it's working like a charm here in New Hampshire. Adam Riley, WGBH News.